JP Morgan is the standout performer, Alexandra. You think that's in some way akin to the performance of the bank and its stock more broadly?
Yeah, well, thank you so much for having me on, Caroline and Annette. But its performance is incredibly strong in terms of its AI maturity. It's head and shoulders above other banks. It was early to the game. Jamie Dimon made AI a focus for the bank 6 years ago, where he made clear that it was going to be an AI-first organization. And from that followed a lot of initiatives like establishing a research lab, you know, doubling down on hiring AI talent, reorganizing the exec team. And that really has paid off. And you see, well, according sort of to our measurements, you can see that they sort of really stand out against other banks and are incredibly strong on AI capabilities.
We've been looking at the data behind JP Morgan's AI hiring. You just made a really interesting point, which is 6 years ago this all started. Let's show the chart. There's the AI hype of 2022, 2023. But if you track the hiring, and what's so interesting, the title of that chart is JP Morgan slows AI hiring. But look how elevated it was in 2022. And it started back in 2020. What do you make of that, about how ahead of the curve or not, so to speak, JP Morgan is?
Yeah, I mean, first of all, it's really important point that you make it in terms of the hype in 22 and 23 of AI, and sort of what we're heading into is more of a let's sort of see what gets through production. It's much harder than we think, and sort of the use cases going from ideation to production just takes a little longer. And some of that slowdown in hiring is also a little bit of a what talent do we actually need? But when you look at that chart, you can see that really being on a hiring tear for the last sort of 6-7 years, and you know the proportion of AI talent and the caliber of AI talent in the bank is second to none. So right now, a lot of the banks are looking at like where, you know, the onset of using, you know, generative AI, where are we using it in the bank, which platforms are we going to use, whether it's OpenAI or Mistral or Hugging Face, which one of those, how does it fit into our particular needs, and how do we refine it so it gives us the best output possible. So there is a bit of a let's see what we can use internally of our AI talent that can help us, you know, refine that and before we sort of accelerate again and think about what we hire externally. But it should also be noted that when you sort of look across the banking sector, even the banks that have cut employees have sort of tried to keep the AI talent sort of relatively steady, if not increasing.
Talking of talent, of course, within that shareholder letter was the demonstration of their commitment to elevating almost to executive level the discussion around AI. And they mention the importance in creating that new position, chief data and analytics officer, that sits in the operating committee. That person over at JP Morgan is indeed Theresa Heitensretter, who I was lucky enough to speak to at an Evident event. And it's notable that she has been galvanizing the focus on sort of from top down, ensuring that all talent are in line with where AI can really bring about a change in productivity. Where are they seeing a drive down in costs? Where are they passing this on to the user of JP Morgan?
Yeah, when it comes to, well, first of all, when it comes to driving the use of AI, and when you sort of look at the letter, is really talking about gaining efficiencies and really making the bank sort of strong and lean and robust for withstanding sort of any macro challenges on you know in the future. So looking at driving down the costs and bringing up efficiency and bringing up productivity and AI being used to also see where you can elevate revenues is sort of in every nook and cranny of the bank, looking at sort of the ways that it can create that return on investment. And then, you know, with the AI tools, that then gets passed on to the customer and, you know, in better customer management, you know, experiences, if time and, yes, and profits too.
Alexandra, do you think Jamie Dimon has a good understanding of artificial intelligence, he himself?
He is an key, saw it very early. He knew it was going to be very impactful. He was one of the first CEOs, bank CEOs, to go out and say, we are changing. We are going to be an AI company or an AI-first company, where many banks would be, we're going to be great banks and using AI to become a little bit better bank. He was a visionary with that. I think he has a good understanding, yes.